Oh yeah, Nate, yeah. Profit Sang. Maybe not five Sang King, but even that.
DY does it.
There you go. Yeah. Yeah, it's every hero we've seen in one of those three roles at some point.
There you go for the Tide. So you got the front line. You got so much team fight on Liquid.
Beef Fella can build a pipe against the Zeus if it is, you know, core Zeus that's going to start doing a lot of damage. Gives you more team fight.
Hmm.
So unclear what Miracle's hero is going to be just yet.
And you have the it's a pipe builder, right? Like that's why it even feels better against Zeus, because you're going to get a pipe. It might even be not even Vlad. You might just go straight up pipe first.
Yeah, Zeus, Sand King, very good pipe game.
It ban out anti-mage. I was thinking that something that can deal with a lot of magic damage would be great right now for Liquid.
And just solo carry game.
Right.
And that's just understanding that Drow is not likely to be this hard carry, and you don't have to pick a Drow partner that benefits from the aura.
Yep. So the hero that you guys are describing is something like a Juggernaut again. We saw Liquid do it earlier.
Okay.
Juggernaut, Lifestealer, both.
Lifestealer, yeah.
Being the magic immunity hero.
I definitely like Juggernaut more than Lifestealer. Because if you're Lifestealing into a 10th pick, I feel Lifestealer has more counters than a Juggernaut does. And Juggernaut plays a lot faster.
The other ones. And we saw Miracle's Troll Warlord yesterday is another option.
I'm trying to see, is there any good, like, ranged carries left? If we are, because you would like to get benefit from a Drow, obviously. I'm just thinking if there's any really good.
They could still go Viper and turn it into a Miracle Drow.
You need so many items as a one position Drow to deal with the bubble, though.
Like, right.
You need to get 4, 5, 6 slot to get that MKB eventually. And then Viper, another range right clicker in a sense.
Yeah. They're probably just going to go with the hard melee here.
They're banning Ursa, so I guess Ursa versus Tide. Yeah. Not about their carry.
Possibility of Sven?
Ooh. Still in the pool, good against Nature's Prophet
Sven
as well.
Really nice.
As Sven gets on top of one of the few heroes who actually gets on top of the Arc Warden, will destroy a Zeus.
And the cleave damage works in the bubble.
Yes. And they don't even know yet. Usually Liquid, they'll go sit down, use some of their last set. They do the jug, so it was our first.
I prefer jug over the Lifestealer anyway, so.
I agree. It just comes online quicker and does more with less.
So do you think this changes how they were going to play the Zeus now that they see that there's this carry that can deal with spells?
I just have no clue with Secret. I really do not.
Whoa, we're at Disney here. Calm down. Sit down, sir, please. 5 seconds remaining. Despicable.
Last pick for Secret.
I think what do you want? You need. You want another like semi carry, I feel. I guess that could be the mind control. Or no, not mind control, sorry, other side. That could be the Zai Nature's Prod still, but I really don't think so.
I think they should look for a mid one hero, but.
Yeah.
Yep. Are you going back for the OD?
No,
it's they Sven. Do Sven. Okay.
So who's playing what?
This is I honestly have no clue. This is quite the draft from Secret.
Mid one, mid Arc Warden.
But Nisha's always the Arc Warden player.
If it is gonna be it's gonna be a Drow middle, right? I actually don't mind the middle Nature's Prophet. We've saw actually mind control on the other side played in the series versus EG. Whoever plays a Nature's Prophet, I think, should go middle in this game.
But I don't think mid one should play it.
No, he will not play it.
Yeah, I think Zai should play it in the mid lane if that's what they want to do.
So there's a lot of unorthodox
question marks
happening in Secret's draft.
If Zai plays the Zeus, I'm going with Secret. Any other way, I think Liquid, they will just run over this game again in 20 to 30 minutes because Arc Warden Bubble definitely slows it down, but Juggernaut, Drow, a ton of team fight in the three middle heroes. It's going to be tough to slow down.
GH Shaker.
True facts.
Say no more.
Say no more.
I will say no more, and neither will you guys, because we are going to start our second game of the grand finals here at the MDL Disneyland Paris Major. Let's head over to OdiePixel and Fogged.
Now, game two, Secret and Liquid ready to go. We have the draft set. Liquid, will they do it once more? Can Secret turn it around here in this game two, Fogged?
A very unorthodox draft by Secret. They're trying to catch Liquid off guard, Liquid having more traditional, their type of style heroes. We'll see.
We'll see. Let's get ourselves into the action. So let's have a look as we get ourselves into this one. So to break it down, to have a look on who's playing what and such, Secret. Now, Grant said, what if it was going to be a Zai Zeus, he would go with Secret to take the game, but it is not. It is going to be the Yapzor Zeus fault.
It is indeed. They're putting Zai on the Sand King. They want to be sure to get him that farm early on, I believe. And yeah, I mean, Yapzor, he has played this in the past. He has played this Zeus a couple times with this team. They have some cool global potential, right? They have this Nature's Prophet plus Zeus if they get to the, you know, the level sixes for them. And also, Arc Warden. Arc Warden kind of is his own global hero in his own sense because he sends those. We look at Liquid's draft. They've got a lot of team fight, just like the panel was talking about. They all don't have the similar reach this game, though, is the one thing I am looking at. They have to get items in order to provide that reach. Well, in the last game, they had Earth Spirit and Morphling, which were natural heroes that can just get on top of Arc Warden, get on top of these backlines. So getting on top of these is going to be a bit tougher this time around.
So if you are Liquid, do you think we are going to see them sort of try and play to a very similar timing as in that game one, you know, with this lineup, considering what you get that pipe online, suddenly you're able to run down lanes, and it's going to be hard for Secret early on to have the deep push required to stop you sieging.
Yeah, absolutely. They have the Jakiro, the Drow, and Jug is a bit of a weird kind of pusher, but he provides Healing Ward, which lets you push also with it. So they do have push again in Secret. They don't have that best objective and building takers. Like, the Sven is okay, the Arc Warden, it takes time for them to be able to in comparison.
We'll see what sort of lane matches we get at the start. Fish is going to be in here as Mind Control is able to take that bounty rune away from Secret. Now I'm going to try by looks of it for the kill as well, blocking Nisha off. GH on the high ground. Nisha trying to get himself away, but GH with the body blocks will set up for that first blood. Puppy will be able to get Mind Control in return. A Puppy, he could be in trouble himself as well as another slow comes out from that dual breath. Puppy is trying to offer as much right click out onto GH. GH gets stunned up. GH still has a Fisher. Can he get it off? He cannot. They'll get the kill on GH and Puppy will stay alive.
Nice TP by Nisha. Rather than TPing to the lane, which you might see people do in your pubs because they see the creeps there, no, he helps his buddy out. So very nicely done. And we do see that Jakiro coming up. He wants the lane versus that Nature's Prophet. We've seen teams pick this so many times now in order to deal with those treants in the lane. But yeah, Puppy gets himself involved in two. Nice and early on for himself as this 5 NP. We see the mid matchup. I saw mid one actually started with 4 slippers of agility, just wanting to have an equivalent base damage versus that Drow Ranger.
And we'll see how sort of a different turn the game takes with mid one playing that Arc Warden this time around rather than the Nisha Arc Warden.
Which will be nice because he's going to get solo experience. He's not in this like super pressure lane that's just risky. Even though Nisha got, I think he was like 2-0-4, even though everything that happened
was
in that bottom lane.
That whole sort of last game, yeah. Nisha was in the top 4 net worth.
But he was experience split. That's the important thing. He was in a tri-lane, so you're not getting that early level 6. You can't actually put pressure as well as that Arc Warden when you get all that split. So we're seeing this lane already playing out. This quad slipper for mid one's definitely working in this first few waves. 6-5 to the 2-1 of the Drow Ranger. Just that better animation for the Arc Warden as well versus that Drow.
Yeah, absolutely crushing it with these first few waves mid bomb. And with the way that the side lanes have settled, looking at the matchups that are there with the 2-on-2s, is there a side that you think is going to have an easier time in these early lanes?
I'm just wondering how the top lane's going to do. Like, how much can Kuroki dissuade and push them away so Mind Control can have a good time? I still think they're going to have a bit of trouble up here. I think Nature's Prophet's just such a strong hero, even when you're playing versus like a Tidehunter, who's pretty good versus Treants and the Jakiro.
And the constant rag click harassment from Puppy, keeping them low enough that it's hard for Mind Control and Kuro to get aggressive onto Nisha.
I think the bottom lane it's still tough for Secret, because even though they have, it's just a Shaker who's really there, pressuring a Juggernaut's very hard, because they're just all magic damage, so.
That mid lane. Atu now starting to catch up a little bit. But mid one definitely the one to take that favorable lead. 9-8, 10-8. A lot of denies in that mid matchup, giving him that tasty XP advantage.
Yeah.
As this top lane Puppy just separating the two heroes. This Nature's Prophet, the power of it in the support position, can just freely offer harass and very little that can be done in return to it. Bottom lane, GH. Taken out by Yapzor, chases him down with the arc lightnings and the right clicks. He'll get the kill on the Shaker. GH is gone.
He had a DD at the start of the engagement as well too, so it must have been him just able to get so many spells off on him. I mean, what, 2 arc lightnings and a lightning bolt, and he did 430 damage, so he got at least like 3 or 4 hits on him as well as the Zeus, because it was just a solo kill. They're not slowing down the jug, though. That's the important thing, at least for Liquid. But getting Yapzor an early kill, that's the dream as your support Zeus. Then you're like, yes, I can get my early Arcane Boots. I can actually use my Lightning Bolts a bit freer to D-ward. And they're playing with a Sand King in their lane, too. So they want to have this Sentry Ward down, but now with the Zeus, they just freely D-ward it every single time. So Zai gets a little bit more breathing room down here, and he won't be at risk of dying here versus this jug anymore.
Yeah, it's especially crucial to take that Shaker out.
Yeah. Top.
As control. He's got an Anchor Smash. But they still got the right clicks. One more will do it. They get him.
He even buys the chainmail while they're going on him during all that, too. Just trying to get that little bit of extra armor to deal with this Blightstone from Puppy, but still too much raw physical.
Bottom, yeah. Ooh, they've got the damage to do it. They'll get Yapzor, unable to TP out in time. So kills on both of the lanes going down, but overall Secret with that slight lead after the first few minutes.
Mid one is really doing a lot of that one there, of course, with these 12 denies, too. He's 10-4 on the drow. Heated battle of last hitting. Grant would be loving this mid lane.
Obviously, Matu will be able to look for catch up in the jungle.
Yeah.
There's going to be that point of the game where you can't imagine he will start to reach it. Sort of a similar CS. So obviously, in terms of actual net worth, it's going to be hard if mid one gets a quick Midas.
Yeah, he's going to hit level 6 pretty early on the drow, and he's going to go to the jungle. And he's going to send probably the Earthshaker to the mid lane to get that experience, or either, I mean, one of the two supports. But the thing is about Secret, they do have ways to at least ward deeply into the enemy jungle without actually being there. Puppy can just actually teleport in and put a ward down to block those Ancients out. It might be a move that he wants to do relatively early on in this game. We will see Bounty Runes start to get contested.
That's GH. Got the stun control for Yapzor Miracle. Play Fury and actually going to look to chase down Zai. Zai's got the Burrow Strike back up. But GH is there, the Fissure. Ooh. It's out. Zai to get the Burrow Strike off in time. He's able to pop this out, the Sandstorm. He'll keep himself alive and start to heal back up.
Top
on the
again.
Top lane, trying with the body blocks. Puppy sprouts there as well, but Mind Control has the Quelling Blade. Cuts his way to freedom and will manage to stay alive. These little players in that mid lane, I mean, we saw as well. The fact that mid one had the Illusion Rune, he literally has not let Matumaman get a single CS or deny within the last minute and a half.
20 denies. He's about to be level 6. Matumaman just hit level 5. He could threaten a kill there.
Bottom.
Zai got him.
Zai. Burrow Strike out.
Nicely
has
done.
To get himself away from that turnaround from Miracle and GH. And Matumaman being forced to TP over to the Shrine. This mid lane, an absolute disaster for Liquid, as
top.
Mid one is going to be right on top of it all. Top. This blocks again. Puppy's trying, but Kuro will get himself past the treants. But this Arc Warden is going to be a huge problem for Liquid. Mid one having one of the best starts of an Arc Warden in the middle lane this game.
And it's mid one. You know he's going to try to play very aggressive on this hero. So that was the moment he hit level 6, he just went on the Drow Ranger just to force him to back off. So we will see GH start to soak that mid lane. And Matumaman's actually jungling before he hits that level 6, which hurts quite a bit here on this Drow Ranger.
Yeah, he just can't come to the mid. He's not going to find anything in that mid lane in that 1v1 matchup
yeah.
now.
And GH also is a melee hero. You have to be pretty careful. As soon as Tempest Double comes up again, you can see mid one definitely try to look to put the pressure on with Double Flux. The TP's coming out. Puppy's already starting to threaten that mid lane a little.
That's bottom lane. Miracle's farm still looking very, very good at the moment. 31 yeah. CS. Even though the constant pressure is there from Zai and Yapzor. He has the healing ward. He has the sustain. To allow him as the jug to stay in the lane.
Mind Control's trying to do anything to be able to survive the damage from up here. But like I said, the chainmail, he also buys a ring of protection on top, just any type of armor he can try to utilize. But I keep seeing Nisha just, he has 3 points in cleave. He's just cleaving off the creeps while Puppy just keeps hitting him with that Blightstone. Do you see the TP coming in? Puppy keep canceling it. It's looking like he wants to just keep threatening in that pressure. Tempest Double? Matumba will get that last hit, that plus 180. Much needed gold for the Drow Ranger.
Still trying to find that. At level 6 on him, as at the same time mid one, he's just hit his level 7. This incredible amount of denying by mid one in the lane, setting him to such a huge lead against Matsu's Drow.
And Yapzor with that level, with the early Arcane Boots, we see him walking around. He's starting to throw those Lightning Bolts, looking for the D wards, like we were talking about from earlier. GH is actually able to get a decent amount in that mid lane these last few waves, not getting pressured out and bullied out by mid one just yet.
But already just his first 8 minutes looking to be a much hotter start for Secret here in game 2.
Absolutely.
All three cores in a very, very good position. Obviously Liquid very close behind. It's only a slight lead. We saw last game what Liquid was able to do with a lead like that. We'll see if Secret's able to do the same here in the second match.
keeping their lanes. I mean, they're definitely very happy right now that Nisha's just getting free farmed. Their mid lane's getting free farmed. They bullied out too. They know Mind Control's being pressured, so they're definitely having a good feel of this game as the God Strength is popped. Mind Control's still a bit tanky.
TP in as well for Kuro. We'll stop Nisha from chasing down any further. Just trying to do their best to push Mind Control out of the lane. They brought Matsu up as well here, Liquid. Not easy for them to make any sort of play, especially with that ward down. Secret know fully well what's going on.
Nisha still has his Ogre Axe in his backpack. He hasn't moved it still. He's had it there for quite a moment now, but he'll move it soon. And yep, Midas very, very close. Level 8 as well. Zai having a much better game. He's going to be going for this rushed Veil build. I've been seeing this a lot more. We saw the Vanguards a lot early on these Sand Kings, but Veil just seems so much better. Gives you the tank ability and just makes your damage potential and threat so high. And they have so much magic damage. It's Miracle Bottom. They're putting the pressure onto him, but he does have the spin. He's holding it as long as he can.
Still struggling to quite get him out of the lane. Just as is the nature of the hero as a Juggernaut. Sand King Zeus, not really the best heroes to go for the kill unless you catch Miracle making a mistake, going too aggressive with a Blade Fury. Then you have a chance, but every time he's got it saved, you're not going to get the kill.
Bit of a farming game going to be coming out here too as we see the Arc Warden mirroring the movement of the Drow Ranger. But bottom, we see that TP.
Going for the Omni Slash Miracle. He's got Blade Fury back up in a few seconds. The lightning isn't quite enough. Miracle is able to keep the distance, get himself back towards the tower. As the Three of Secret, not quite able to get him back towards top. Nisha, he's got a TP out, but they've got the Ice Bath, the right click damage from Matu. It's enough. As soon as they see Secret try and come down bottom and make a play onto Miracle, Liquid are instantly on top of Nisha's Sven.
Absolutely. Just that quick mirror movements we're seeing coming out from both sides. They get some deep vision that they've had for actually a couple moments now too. And Miracle surviving during all that, yeah, so important. He might get gone immediately again down bottom.
He's not got the mana for the Blade Fury. Well, now he has. That one charge that he got there from the initiation from the two of them will get him out.
Nice for Liquid that they're able to pressure this top tower now off of getting that kill. This top lane was being pretty tough here for Mind Control, but now with this rotation from Matumbaman, they will get that one. As we see Secret, they're farming up for their level 6s. Puppy almost having that one. They're actually looking to contest this top. The Arc Warden is getting brought up there too. Zai's here.
挺大的，然后苏恩也是因为死了一次，但是经济还是非常好。是的，现在比赛继续开始。哎，这里是先杀了一个哈皮的先知酱油味的一换移，杀王也是选了一个下路，苏恩直接是开大招，配合车过来推塔，主宰回家补过之后再踢出来。
他们这个沙王出分正面杀，等会儿一个戳配合宙斯的技能会打出很高的输出。
对，
秘密这一局的阵容，他的输出是比较立体的，就是沙王、宙斯的法系爆发，加上斯温和电狗的物理输出。
对，电狗也有法系爆发，就输出非常非常多。
对，然后液体的话，可能阵容是胜在团战，有两手团控，可以给大哥更好的输出环境。 小牛这局还是比较肥的。中路小黑双头龙想过来推一波塔，这个塔秘密应该是肯定不会放。沙王裸了一个纷争，但是液体这个阵容呢，感觉不太好找小节奏。
哎，这波加速主宰，
看到了一个残血斯温有斩，
应该不行。
没有爆燃胶
，TP 也 CD 的，没有赚TP的说法。是的，上路的纷争沙王对潮汐有想法。
没队友，
收一下，收一下线。 主宰之力的奶棒，放了一个分裂体过来点掉小兵，再放一个磁场，他磁场是没有给塔，给的是自己的这个分裂体。嗯，大王也过来，直播塔，哎，哦，这个远程的配合直接是让小黑的血条瞬间消失。哇，先知飞后排，收掉双头龙，主宰开转，但是感觉情况不对，只能撤了。等下一个刺，他一秒钟给了乱流，往前跟刺到宙斯，一番技电流走大，想拼宙斯，三连A一下宙斯，紫剑放了技能。
长视野看放大，
对，双大齐开，这里没断的电狗，很残血，一个双刺救了一下，电狗反而长视野反牛头，反杀两人，
这波秘密分针面杀立功了，这把，
是
分针面杀远程穿刺，然后配合宙斯跟先知双大，小黑瞬间被秒，
对，然后等第二个分针面杀
CD
一好，又反杀两个，这一波秘密的技能释放非常的到位，打了液体一波团灭。
虚灵刀，拉了一个虚灵刀，想把这个法系伤害提到极致吗？这样他就是复狗的虚灵刀也可以跟沙王、宙斯、先知打配合。不得不说，这一局秘密的这个阵容选择还是想法非常的天马行空啊！而且他们打出这样的效果，小黑绝对没想到他这个吃一个小星星直接死了。
看一下这波，满血小黑，
分针，一个宙斯大家，先知大加上一个闪光幽魂，小黑被秒，
剑圣没转也被追死，
对，这一波应该就是打了液体一个出其不意，没想到潮汐第一时间不在，被打了一波团灭。
这波沙王分针面杀和一二技能 CD 好了，对，最后的一个双刺也很漂亮，加埋杀双杀，是的。
那秘密是领先了4000经济。主宰选择在战鼓之后补狂战，想靠一己之力在后期翻盘，但是我觉得这盘的难度有点大。
嗯，秘密现在优势这么大，不会给你那么多刷钱空间的。
先手锤到双头龙，四分是没有深追。
而且就是液体这一盘翻盘似乎只能靾团战，他没有什么特别好的小节奏点。下路先手的狂风沉默到斯温是有点落单了，对，这个妮莎有点不应该啊。主宰替中守塔。 沙王也是更新了一把跳刀，跳刀在埋伏这边，踢中想打中，这波潮汐不在中，中上摇大直接动手， 双头龙中他把气爆发被秒掉，这里板两个位置也不错，走过来个大招。 先知被击杀，沙王在树林里面残血，
潮汐现在还有大，沙王是吃了一个恢复，等刺的
CD，
哎，牛头要被切被锤，牛头被切，
正面潮汐踩大招，一个穿刺刺过来，电狗再反过来输出，妮莎先切死牛头，
先知买活飞后排，
买活飞想留这个潮汐，等沙王的下一手跳刺，发现给了一个视野，潮汐应该是跑不掉的，直接刺过来给了斯温视野锤住。
这波是大哥都没有死，这个中塔可以拿掉，这一局在的沙王跟上一局的效果是完全不一样啊，上一局沙王比较穷，感觉全场没什么声音，然后这一局一个很肥的沙王，对面又是一个比较笨重的阵容，沙王打得很灵活，这把在证明自己，对，这把感觉秘密的很多人都想证明自己，上一局被打得很憋屈很难受，是的。 啊，小牛有跳，但暂时没大。下路想配合主宰包一下这个宙斯。
先知甩了一个双头龙，这秘密这个杀人他的太难预判了，他有太多这个远程支援的技能，先知宙斯双大，包括电狗的这个复制体随时都可以来。 基本就是杀王刺一个人，这个人就可能要掉很多血。而且在的杀王现在一直处于一个 miss
状态，所以液体的人打钱都是很小心的。对，爆发实在是太高了。
哎，吃了个隐身，这样进攻性更强了。不过这个隐身是被液体合到眼看到的，点好针眼。
要开始爆眼了，补刀、辅加、真加眼准备好。哎，
这波
有个视野，看见小黑跟正面杀王大招，配合一个先知大，埋杀的伤害更好。
直接单杀了，这个小树人在这边。
也需做一个移动眼位，
移动眼位乱逛，然后直接逮到小黑。现在液体被压制的有点难受，先知飞上落，这里
Crocky
被电狗杀掉，潮汐往前跟有大招想留，你都往近身，剑圣也靠过来，
对，踩大，电狗爆了，磁场剑圣被断了一手，直接交斩，哎，斩上去又回来了，还有一个在的杀王被粉到，有刺直接转。
杀王想 A 奶棒被牛E了一下，还有穿刺刺走，四龙也来了，跳走，这波秘密是不打了。刚才 Miracle 这个运气其实也算比较正常吧，应该就两个单位嘛。这个时候这个宙斯一直在偷偷发育啊。对，小黑准备裸出 BKB， 对面这个法上实在太高，受不了。
这样中期的话，液体还是找到机会断了秘密窗和发育的节奏，没有让电狗跟斯文保持无解肥。两个大哥还是死过的。二重生赏金符，液体上路想吃对面的符，被先知的一个发芽直接把路给封了。啊，秘密三符。 斯文 BKB，
主宰刚刚狂战，小黑魔龙枪现在应该是液体的一个装备真空期，就战斗力还不是很强。但是秘密这个阵容的技能已经很强了，现在液体的活动范围非常的小。 哎，我们看到Papi这个先知的树人啊，
一直在
地图上这个小粉点，一直在找人，一直在给这种移动视野，
很细操作。对，配合一个飞鞋杀王，
打的这个全球流，
打的液体很难受，刷钱空间被压缩的太小了。
对。 现在液体只有自己的三角区的真假眼部的比较满，是比较安全的。主野区已经被树人侵占了，然后潮汐是到对方的野区，比较危险的地方打钱。哎，又看到小牛的位置。下路这波推塔，其实秘密来的人不是很多，现在还是在等这个电狗刷装备。斯文 BKB 之后没有着急出山，继续刷。
液体好像想组织一波进攻，
潮汐出的还是笛子，
先一起来守一下这个下路二塔，因为也不知道对面这个时候下路这边到底有多少人。
对，杀王摇大，直接被冰打断了。刺走，牛头这里能跟进，给了一个板跳翼留住，在这里应该是要死了。这一波想打一个远程配合，
是直接被看到了。
对，宙斯还差400多 A 杖。 啊，这电狗是已经虚灵刀了，他应该是在等一双飞鞋，然后跟沙王配合。 Miracle 主宰狂战之后应该补的还是比较快的，进入到一个对刷的时间。
那这边也准备把野区找回来了，这双瞳也在野区到处铺眼，野区入口铺好眨眼，
对吧？双瞳龙就是爆眼了，没办法。现在秘密应该是在等自己这个装备中期的一波成型，就是沙王电狗双飞鞋配合宙斯 A 杖大招，然后这个纷争跳刺，基本上刺到的人预估一下可能就得掉个1500血左右，我觉得。哎，沙王纷争跳刺，宙斯 A 杖大，宙斯大，先知大，电狗过来分裂体还能给虚灵，对吧？这个远程的法伤。哎，宙斯 A 杖有了，这里秘密准备启动，小黑是更新了 BKB，
可以看得出来这个秘密确实节奏点一直在。
哎，看一下分钟跳刺，宙斯 A 杖大招电两下，自尊跳锤开大，先知飞过来，不丹超级直接被杀掉，没有悬念。侧翼还有一个主宰有刺，刺起来第二手控没跟上，主宰直接转 TP， 目前还是无敌的。哎，但是双头龙过来反眼是被发现
啊，这边先被先知偷偷做了一个高塔眼。
哎，小黑，
小黑也被扫了。
BKB 好像没开出来，直接 TP， 斯文判断了伤害不够，直接回头，没有浪费时间。
上路抓到机会拆二塔，但秘密这个队确实节奏点还是在身上啊，上把在对线很优劣势的情况下，秘密这个队就没什么节奏。
是的，
这把沙王站了出来。
潮汐复活之后，液体应该是想找机会求一波团的，被秘密这样无限压制的话，经济差会越拉越大。我们看到秘密的这个英雄输出斯文反而是最低的，
对，全是技能的输出，基本上
对。哎，又启动了比赛，摇大跳刺想杀 Miracle， 这波镜头反救了一手 Miracle 残血开出了。
先知大晚了一点点，
对，应该想参一点最高伤害，反斩沙王一个刺躲开了，但是被沉默到这一波液体的人都在奇迹哥附近，
想一个人配合远程技能直接杀掉奇迹哥啊，就是大没好处。
对，技能不齐这一波，齐的话应该死了。这波击杀不够完美，液体抓一个机会，沙王不在过来控盾，但是目前他们的这个装备落后情况还是不太好打的，
被发现了。
选择了一波开悟转移，想
这边看有眼看到了妮莎，
对，妮莎是有 BKB 和跳刀的。
先手有牛头，
而且先知的这个站位和点眼，
先知破雾了
啊，先知先破雾，跳板没板到，没视野。这波秘密要不要反打直接 TP？ 这个 TP 有点，哎，这个还不开 BKB 啊，就直接死了。哇，妮莎
这把
啥意思呢？
有点失误啊，这几波。
我以为他就是说他能开库 BKB 超级放大，他也没开出来，对吧？
然后牛头其实没有大到他那个余震，也没开 BKB， 他放弃了。
本来我以为他这个 TP 是想秀潮汐的，就是你放大我就开 BKB， 骗你个大招我也能走，对吧？结果失误了。这一盘妮莎的失误还是比较多的。
看 Mid One 的电狗现在是经济第一，看他的发挥了。
在虚灵飞鞋之后又补了一个推推，这样更方便自己能去跟进技能。目前还是一个偏技能流的电狗，物理伤害不是很高。中期秘密还是有点被断节奏的，这个经济差是没有能够拉开，选择过来控盾了，点好视野，液体一个扫描发现，劫持过来，沙王，哎，刺晚了一点，宙斯放大招还是能杀，
还是秒了。
这个伤害，我觉得这个伤害好像除了撑血量之外没啥办法呀，就一定要保证能吃这么多伤害，不然就会被秒。
就出魔抗然后撑血量，
对吧？
或者打到后面出盘子。
秘密抓了波节奏过来把盾控到， 也是感觉自己中期打得有点随意，给了对面一点机会，稳一下。哎，看一下沙王下路，想蹲小黑这波线，有飞鞋比较隐蔽，有大招，
有机会
小黑露头摇大跳刺，看马桶哥的反应不够快，直接被打成残血，先是包后排，电狗飞过来，
直接死。在的抓机会能力还是强，
是的，这个小黑也没什么办法，对吧？你说要求一个选手躲开沙王的跳刺，
太难了，
太难了，可能就得你提前意识到沙王可能会蹲这波线。这一波秘密下路线升到高地，这波上高可能，哎，这一段真身推开朝西，没有跟技能被断了，后排牛头的位置很残血，也是推了一手，这主宰过来输出，再被晕住，逆杀过来一个锤，先打朝西，朝西有点肉没杀死，框两个不太好跟技能了，沙王是秘密阵容的控制核心。
只要沙王一死，
哎，这里想留人液体，牛头踢圣坛，留了一个先知，
买活，
沙王买活，看一下这波怎么说。潮汐目前是梅兰放大的一个状态，有点尴尬，应该是要撤。妮莎跳锤 Crocky， 沙王纷争一下，刺还没有交，宙斯大招给照了一个视野，液体人都在高地上。
秘密这个阵容想要杀人，感觉离不开沙王啊。
是的，
没有沙王，对面很难控住。
Miracle 刷了一个分身，继续刷下一件出蝴蝶，竞技领先9000，双头龙补出一个挑战。其实这样打的话，感觉秘密的这一套秒杀流是越来越不好用了。
对，打到往后打对面大哥成型了，你这个秒杀流就没那么好用了。
是的，因为你是靠技能秒杀的，就是你的伤害是比较固定的。
对，
但对面的装备是有成长性的，所以这个时候秘密应该也是要加快一点节奏。斯温看到了潮汐直接开大，
哇，这波大招双倍幅想上来 A 塔。
刚才我觉得他如果先锤的话应该是能杀的，转中这波双倍加大招只破了一个二塔，其实中期秘密还是错失了一些机会的。
就是往后打，就这个电狗的发挥空间会很大。看这个电狗的发挥。
对，先知刷了一个大招，这个秘密的阵容确实消耗能力很强。哇，啪皮的先知
虚灵刀，
裸了一个虚灵刀，那既可以提升法伤，也可以防止对方的物理伤害。因为液体这个阵容还是一个双物理核心，
他们就是要打护救，然后来拖住对面的物理核心的输出。
对，这样算上电狗大的话，秘密是有三把虚灵。
对，
这个剑圣好难斩人啊，
剑圣小黑都输出不到人。
扫到了，
这波扫描意识很到位，读到了液体的一个进攻，上路 Miracle 露线其实也是一个比较明显的信号，
但下路电狗已经要逼到高地上去了，这波有两台车。
对，这波电狗带车，液体只能回防，确实这一局电狗的空间太大了。
这个而且这个剑圣下路线根本不敢带出去。
是的，
下路野区是没有视野的，带出去随时有暴毙的危险。
这一波开悟就是在对方野区做了两个假眼，能得到一些信息。宙斯下一件是要出一个吹风，已经18级的宙斯了。斯文的话是出大炮，打到中期啊，我反而觉得现在秘密他们的这个装备更新没有太多质变装可以更新了。
对，只是一件一件的在堆装备。
电狗是更新了一个大电锤，提升了一下输出。中路是一个真电狗，中路是一个真电狗。
但是刚收，已经收完了这波兵，来不及。
现在是一个假电狗。
假电狗也可以破雾的。他也是一个英雄单位。
看到一个大潮汐，哇，假电狗
打一
套，
对，
把奶棒 A 掉，
看到谁打谁，
就曹鑫，这一顿打，只
从中路打到家门口，
只能跑。
而且对面的人全 miss 的情况下，其实剑圣也不太敢出来去 A 这个假电狗。你 A 电狗分裂体的话，中对面一套控制，如果斯温在场，真的可能会死。
是的，买了一个宝石 Puppy， 这时候控制视野相当关键。发现一个小黑来了，
小黑是在眼下呢，
小黑在眼下，
对，
来了，
还是被刺到了，一套技能虚灵给上，开启 BKB 往回走。
他这样就算没有杀掉你大哥，但是给你的压力是太大了，然后你也打不到钱，
至少你 BKB 是避开的，
对，
前几波 BKB 全用来逃命，后面五秒 BKB 之后其实还是比较容易被技能打
上，沙王
又来上，哇，这个沙王
好灵活，
无处不在，加上地图上的很多假眼，哇，这波 Mirror 反应真的快，没刺到，现在秘密应该是准备在这种抓人节奏当中呢，顺便等一下斯温的强袭，等斯温装备成型，再把下一代入山控到之后，应该会组织一波进攻。
先知飞、
哎、找到一个双头龙，斯温过来
要留剑圣，把奶棒 A 掉。
正面打起来的话呢，秘密人来的也很快，所以液体除非是五个人在一起，不然是不敢轻易反击的。
是的。啊，
宝石给了沙王，
来翻眼了。
经济压制到了14000，啊，这是电狗准备出羊刀了。
感觉这样打下去，经济只会越拉越远啊。
对，现在双方地图上可打钱的范围差距太大了。液体现在只有对方高台有一个假眼，地图基本是全黑，而且对面这个阵容就是有秒人能力的，特别是像小黑这种。只能是选择让人蹲，然后换向片片技能之类的。
这边秘密又吃一个四伏，
对，
经济又拉开了。
但就好像在这个沙王就手里拿着一个开关，
对，
他只要摁一下，你这个人可能就会死。
哎，
这波沙王露下点针眼，说再给机会了吗？走大，直接秒杀。吹风了一下，落地之后反跑，暂时没死，啊，死出来
还
是
死
了，100秒不能买活沙王。
这个宝石好像掉了吗？
宝石应该是掉了，
宝石掉了。
这波再还是给了点机会啊，他露头了。但这波两路线都不好，盾也没刷，液体这波缴了一个宝石。沙王应该上一波是买活的，所以这波阵亡时间很久。
对，那这个时间段感觉剑圣可以打好多钱。
对，
他只要沙王不在，应该很难威胁到他。
中路来威胁小黑了，但是这个虚灵电狗，
又把小黑的 BKB 打出来，
没办法。
哎，先知
被留，双头龙加潮汐，
牛头在赶了，有一个板，那应该是死了。
是的。抓了两个人盾刷新，但先知也不能买，
这波是个机会吗？
斯温过来锤到一个盾的双头龙，自己没有敢深追，眼还是被反掉了，宙斯给了一个技，但这波技能不是很齐，潮汐跳过来被秒吹风，亚姆特被冰住，宙斯被击杀，这里妮莎开启大招，但是被板隔到了路，被封住了，不能输出，只能往回撤，剑圣没有深追。现在秘密是三人阵亡，迷途电狗做出了羊刀，找到了
牛头，
哎呦，直接秒了，
一个暴击直接秒掉，
这牛头站位被发现了，
有羊刀了，
这出的 S 不小心了
，BKB 呢？没开出 BKB，
潮汐只能放大说护一下，怕被飞脸，小黑狂风再掩护，牛头也买活，潮汐被留，给了一个虚灵，再锤速。这里秘密也没有深追，主宰的展示还没有交
啊 ！BKB 已经用过了上一波。
刚才主宰被养，他是没有 BKB 的。
我说那个斯温，
对，
他上波已经把 BKB 用过了。
这一波的话是牛头交了买，肉山盾已经刷新了，这波盾团应该是非常关键的，但是潮汐暂时没大招，只能去卖。
电狗又在下路开始带了，
对，这个下路线一直被电狗这样无限消耗，
是的，酱油也不好去守，
是的，
去守容易被电狗直接杀了，
这样的话 Liquid 就要么放一路，要么就是正面少人，
嗯，
只能做这样一个选择题，选择还是让主宰去守。宙斯放大招给了一个视野定位，对面是四一分开的，主宰25级点了生命，这样不太容易被秒。但是秘密呢也不急打盾，因为他知道我不打盾你这四个人永远不敢离开，但是我可以分散打钱，我可以抓点小节奏，
开悟去下路线上找人，
嗯，在的沙王买了一个绿杖自保之后直接是准备出大根，这是秘密就要把秒杀流打到极致，就要秒人，我就要刺一个秒一个。电狗的分裂体去给视野打点信息，
嗯，这剑圣也是不敢出来收线，刚才现在队友靠过来了才出来收了两波。
Miracle 还是不选择出 BKB，
准备出晕锤，
对，他也是感觉这个格子有点不够用了。斯文强袭，妮莎的斯文应该是装备成型六神装，
先
一体还是
去看一下肉山，
对，
下路又来了，
嗯，还是一样的剧情，但是这个塔早晚会被这样耗掉啊。剑圣直接是跳进磁场开分身砍电狗的分裂体，但是反手中了一个羊，地上过来不见
到吗，
跳锤直接秒了，
锤还没有锤到，直接就秒了。
对，没有交锤，然后牛头也阵亡，不能买斯文 BKB， 一刀秒了双头龙，两人买活，斯文往回退一下，主宰落地开转，
先打掉雷云，
想杀斯文，斯文跳走，潮汐不好追了。我们看到这一波远程的法系爆发还是非常的高，
对，虚灵刀，然后再加各种技能，
嗯，虽然说主宰点了生命，但是毕竟还是一个敏捷英雄，甲高血低，面对对方的这个法系伤害是没用的，是吧？ Mid One 已经完善远程遥控了，
嗯，
又是秘密一个四伏，然后秘密过来控盾，牛头是不能买的，他们知道这波没有牛头，液体应该是没法接这波盾团。
来了，还是想
还是要硬接吗？有个加速符，秘密打得很快啊，放了磁场，盾被打掉，妮莎拿盾过来，电狗留人，没羊出来。现在主宰是不能买活的，
嗯
，Miracle 不允许再有任何的失误了，打了一个宙斯先手的 A 杖大招。
啊，这宙斯是没有学眩晕吗？
好像是的，找到了多眼的双头龙杀掉，这个也是买活的，90秒不能买，一个锤到了 Miracle， 潮汐过来，但是斯文有盾，虚灵了小黑，是的，秘密消耗的手段有很多。电狗的分裂体已经上了，一个磁场上去给视野耗塔，主宰不敢露头，塔被点掉，没办法。这波两部车，沙王藏在树林，宙斯一张大招给视野，牛头被看到了，推一手，主宰开转，主宰马上没转，逆塔开大招，拆建筑，还是以拆建筑为主，没冲，
直接把潮汐打跑，
对面两个人残血，只能回家，塔防也没了。秘密回到一路高地的转中路，潮汐买了一个雾，这波液体要打先手，但是秘密撤了。嗯，斯文没大了，潮汐跳脸，但是视野位置不好。秘密还是挺稳的，
这个电狗还是装备太好了，
是的， 而且这个电狗的分裂体带一手羊刀虚灵和飓风长戟，自保能力也挺强的，你想杀这个副狗也不太容易。宙斯点了15%冷却减少。
他这个冷却减少其实是不会减少他那个雷云的打击频率的。
其实我觉得这一局他是可以点眩晕的。
对，他这个眩晕其实很关键。
他这个眩晕的话就可以打一个先手。
对，他可以打一个先手眩晕，然后沙王可以接跳戳，斯文也可以接跳锤。
是的，
是很关键的。
对，这个宙斯的先手眩晕应该是无解晕。然后沙王再接刺，容错率就会高一点。看到了对面五个人的位置。哦，斯文是装了一个双倍，找机会喝一下。上路直播盾还有2分钟，应该是要来一波了。这一波主宰没有买，牛头没有买，双头龙没有买，小黑潮汐又买，两个买活，把两路线带好。
双倍斯温已经开启，又要来耗一波高地。
对，回音刀提上来，真男人斯温拆电果分裂体赶人，潮汐过来吓唬了一下，斯温还没开大塔先点掉，锤了一下潮汐，给了一个分争，砍了一刀，宙斯放了一个雷云，潮汐残血，小黑狂风了一下，沙王还在看情况，又给了一手虚灵，小黑也残血，还是掩护斯文拆，不急，这路看着就没了，没了。这样秘密是没教什么技能，就感觉秘密这样拆液体，
有点毫无办法。
对，
因为毕竟带个盾，这斯文，
除非潮汐跳大就直接开团。这一波机会，液体主动求团了，但他们是没视野的，而且这个闪光幽魂能看雾，盲跳大，单踩一个斯文，盲斩，斩了两个幻象。
但是斯文有盾，
这波技能算是交空。看一下秘密的一个
沙王留人，直接的。BKB
被一个板隔了一下，但潮汐还是死了，小黑也被发压框住，加电狗的物理输出，小黑阵亡，不能满活。双头龙这个位置残血放出一道技能也被击杀，密度按双杀，潮汐满活，但是液体已经没有技能了。沙皇跳高地留人，给自己一个绿料开视野，刺还没交，中了个大晕，前秒沙王的给个板，能护到死吗？学生救了一手，
吹风
吹自己落地可以刺走，刺了一个比较短的距离，跳一跟上沙皇阵亡，可以买沙王，买活可以飞过来，这一波液体还是三人应战，都没技能，
那要被拆超级兵了。
鸣人和跳到脸上，跟斯文刚正面中了一手虚灵刀，中路已经被拆出，还差一个远程兵营，马上超级兵了，没有办法呀，
拆出超级兵。
这一波的话呢，是液体在被迫两路之后选择了一波开雾，没有视野情况下的一波盲打。潮汐盲跳大加剑圣的盲斩，但是最终的效果只斩死妮塔两个幻象，那这样的开端结局也就可想而知了。
一个
杨座在边上输出，哈尼虚灵是自己，不过感觉影响已经不大了，带着38000的经济领先，液体只能被赶回泉水，
被堵住了。
潮汐阵亡，不能买活，这边大云要杀掉这个哈尼，这一把帕比虚灵自己，这个先知也很肥，没死。Miracle 阵亡，应该是宣告比赛结束。RP 敲出 GG， 恭喜 Secret 在第二局扳回一局，把双方的 BO5 拉到了 BO3， 回到同一起跑线。
也是展示了秘密的强大。
是的，在第一把被 Miracle 的水人主宰之后，第二把通过 BP 上的一个策略调整，这一盘赢得也非常的漂亮。恭喜秘密扳回一局，我们也是把剩下的时间交给分析台。